Hey guys, just want to say again, in case you haven't seen the last two episodes, there was something wrong with my recording, so there is no audio of my own voice, so it is just going to be, you know, the gameplay itself. So, hope you guys still enjoy it. Please watch the other ones if you haven't done so already, and expect more soon. Have a good day, everyone. Bye-bye.
Location is being distributed now. Going in front of you.
Violence erupted last night in Rossi, Fremont. The notorious neighborhood has suffered a wave of violence over the last few years as members of the Black Viceroys clash over gang leadership. Police officials see no end to the violence.
Sorry guys, it took me all that time just
to... I haven't been to Nikki since the funeral. Am I ready? Jack's last birthday, Lena sang off key. Happy birthday. Full throttle, no holds barred. Now, I'm afraid of the silence.
They need to crack down on DedSec.
Why in the world do you care so
much? Maybe they fucked with my system, maybe they didn't. That's the problem. How could anyone know?
Somebody tried to break into my house.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. They were just here. Squad car and everything. I told you no more hacking under my roof. I gave you fair warning.
Mom, listen, I didn't do anything. Just some harmless pranks, that's all.
You get your things, and you get out.
That's right. Hey!
Okay.
How old are you today?
Ten. No, I think you're nine.
I'm ten.
Nine.
Ten.
Nine.
Ten?
Well, in that case, you deserve 10 birthday tickles.
What? 1, 2, 3, 4, Whoa. 5, 6, Stop. 7, 8, Whoa. 9,
10. 10.
10. Stay here for a second. So, an entire year and...
Late. Yeah, I'm sorry, Nate. Really.
Come here. Let's have a look at you. You look older.
Oh, nice. Thanks for that.
It's his first birthday without Lena.
How's he doing?
Still doesn't talk to anybody but me. Yolanda says it's his way of maintaining some sort of control.
Yolanda?
His therapist. She's helping him. It's good. Just slow. It's hard, but we're gonna get through it. Mm-hmm. Jax.
And Puerto Rican.
Hey. Sorry I'm late. Can I get a hug? Wow. You are big. So, hey, what you got there? Wow, the healer. Cool. You bought him a real toy, huh?
Why don't you bring up your toys? I'm gonna speak with your uncle.
Yeah, I'll be up there in a sec.
This matters. You being here. I just need to make sure that things are different.
Things are different. You and Jax are the most important people in my life. I'm not gonna stop watching out for you.
Always the big brother, huh?
Last time I was back here, it was Lena's birthday. Jackson adored her. We all did.
You missed all the fun. The kids were playing vigilante, imitating that guy they keep talking about on TV.
Let me guess. Jax was the vigilante.
No, they were all the vigilantes, and I was the only villain, but I make a mean bad guy. I gave him hell.
I should have come earlier. I could have warned them. Don't mess with my sister.
Remember when you and Mom were both sick as dogs, but Dad insisted his boy was gonna have his birthday cake? That thing was an abomination, all burnt and lopsided. That was Dad in a nutshell. He did a lot of ugly things, but it was always about family. Listen to me, I'm rambling. Oh, really? No, don't let me interrupt you. Who is this? You think blogging caller ID will hide you? I don't know what's so entertaining, but the police won't find it very funny at all. I'm gonna give you some advice. Are you listening? Go outside. Listen, the police can trace this call. Oh, nice. You don't scare me.
I know where you live. How are the locks on those doors?
Who is this? Why are you calling?
Do you feel safe, Nikki?
Who was that?
Doesn't matter, just some stupid crank. It happens. Do you think this is strong enough?
Look, did you know his voice?
Oh, Jesus, Aiden, just leave it. It's fine.
It's fine? He thinks he can get inside.
How do you know what he thinks?
You're checking the locks.
Look, I can handle this on my own. We do not need your help.
Nikki, I can find this guy.
Okay, look, Aiden, God, you have not changed at all. We do not need your help. Please stop trying to fix our problems. Every time you try, you just make things worse.
I better go.
Yeah, I think that's a good idea.
Grown man making crank calls. Let's see how safe you feel when I trace your call. There you are. Damn it! He's on the move! Nikki, who would pay for something like that? Did you get anywhere with DedSec? Any of those CTOS hacks?
Yeah, I'm still trying. They're checking you out. Give me time.
Okay, well, I need your help then. Can you trace a phone call?
How can I refuse my best client? Wait, what am I looking at here?
It's from a guy who threatened my family. I want to know who hired him.
Well, the call came from somewhere in the Loop District. But that's as far as I can see.
Okay. I can hack CTOS inside the Loop.
Then I should be able to pinpoint the source of that call.
Let's do that. Loom's building a new CTOS center in the Loop. It's perfect.
DedSec tried to attack that center last month. We failed, and they just added more armed guards. So it won't be easy. Be careful.
You sound like my sister. Relax. Make sure I'm armed and dangerous. Loom hires private contractors to guard their CTOS centers. These guys will be geared up and wired for action. But I'll be ready.
Hey, you! Look at me, asshole!
Hey!
Back off, shithead!
Enjoy.
What the hell?
Go.
You're welcome.
Not good. Not good.
Get out.
Oh! Oh, no! I don't want to get shot.
What the
TOS doubles their guards. I better double my weapons.
Nice day, isn't it? Finding everything okay?
Over the past few weeks, CTOS centers throughout Chicago have increased security due to several attacks from activist hacker group DedSec. When asked about security changes, Bloom spokeswoman Charlotte Gardner was decisive.
Chicago's safety is paramount, so we've hired private security for every CTOS control center. These highly skilled peacekeepers have trained in the most dangerous regions of the world.
In fact, Ms. Gardner, these peacekeepers you refer to are military mercenaries, many with criminal records, isn't that true?
Indeed, they've served time in the military, but we should hardly reject our brave soldiers for proudly serving their country, should we? Our CTOS network is well protected, and that gives Chicago citizens the comfort they deserve.
That was Bloom spokeswoman Charlotte Gardner discussing CTOS security.
See ya.
He's no joke. I need access. Gotta find out who's targeting my family. I want that voice behind the phone call.
looks clear. I'm heading that way. This area's clear. I'm moving on. I got nothing. I'll check over there.
Looks clear. I'll head that way.
I don't see anything. Gonna move on.
It's clear. We gotta check somewhere else.
There's nothing here. Moving on.
Hold on. I wouldn't relax just yet.
I got nothing. I'll check over there. Looks clear. I'm heading that way.
I got nothing. I'll check over there.
Investigating suspicious activity.
What was that? That's inside someone's home. Looks like CTOS is compiling every intimate detail from private citizens. It's no wonder DedSec despises CTOS.
CTOS already?
I'm looking at the network as we speak. You've got your access, and I've got mine. Profiler system's online. Everybody's nasty little secrets at the click of a button. This thing's highlighting all kinds of stuff in the district. I could take advantage of some of this.
Keep an eye out for online traffic. Could be fixers in the network.
If I can see them, they can see me. All right, I gotta move. I mean, a lot of noise here.
Give me time to track your caller. I'll be in touch.
Hey, I need you to cover something for me.
What is it?
I lined up a lucrative deal with a very demanding client. He needs a driver.
No.
But here's the thing. I come in this morning, find Maurice trying to dig his way out of the guest room. So I need to move him. Now I could pass this problem on to you, since Maurice is really your problem. But that's not my style. I always finish what I start, and all I'm asking of you...
All right. Fine. I'll handle it.
Well, no, don't let me push you out.
I said I'd handle it. It's the job. Exactly.
It's a delivery job. Gotta move some guy. I mean, how hard is that? Just keep in mind my reputation's on the line here. He's paying top dollar for the best driver in Chicago.
Then he's in luck.
wild by the whole blown vision at first, just like you. I bought into the whole marketing package, the betterment of life through hyperconnectivity and all that. Sure, they do that stuff. They are visionaries up at the top. Humanitarians. Bloom is helping to educate the underprivileged. They've gone green. They fund everything from social programs to medical research. These things are real. But you know whose desk I'm sitting in? Raymond fucking Kenny. That'll wake you up real fast.